Welcome back. This time, as promised, we are going to work on our Misko head. So as you know, we've been working on our Misko pattern, and this time we are going to be working with pattern pieces number 12 and number 13. There you go. That's the ear. And then the underside of the face, which is 14. Now this video is going to be just a little bit longer, and we're going to have some stop and starts so that I can kind of get to each section. We're going to start off with adding the ears, and I'm going to talk a little bit about preparing to add the eyes. And so what I've done in advance is I have sewn the inner and the outer ear together. So you can see there's the pink side, and there is the outside, what we call the right side. Now, once you've done this, the next thing we have to do is sew the ear so that we can get the inner detail of the ear. Now, I've done one in advance to kind of show you, and I've sewn half of the face. And so you can see here we want to create this inner ear. And so when it's up tall, you can kind of see the pleat in the middle. And then when we scrunch it down, excuse me, then we can see the nice shape of the ear. Now to get that shape, what we do is we fold the ear in half, right sides together, outside together, okay? And you're going to stitch right along this back edge. After we do that, then we'll pull these front edges together and create that pleat. Now, here's the important part. When you are pinning the face together, so let me show you on the pattern. You can see here we're going to pin it to the inside so all this comes together. What you're going to get is a slight gap in the area for the ear to allow the extra material to go around the ear, because you can see once we put all these layers together, can you see how thick that is? So we have to make some allowance in the pattern to go around that bulkiness of the ear. So when you're pinning, this is really important. You want to pin from the tip down by the nose and pin up halfway, and then come around and pull these edges together. Okay, can you see that? So you're going to take this and this and pull them together and pin here. And then continue to pin all the way up, and you'll find that there's a gap. And that's where you're going to insert the ear. Now the other thing that we need to remember is the ear has a shape. See this little curve? And so the tips curve inward, in towards the nose, not outward. And so you can see when I put this ear together, here's my tip, and there's a small little curve in here, and that tells me which side of the face to put on. So when you're adding your ear, make sure you have the ear that goes on the right side so that they'll curve inward. Ultimately, they'll face each other like this, okay? So if I pull it inside out, I can show you the area that I have sewn, starting from the tip and going around, and then you can see how the ear is in that space here. Now, although I usually wait to add the eye after I have the full face assembled, I wanted to go ahead and show that to you now for the purposes of our video. So, as you can see here, I've added our eye, and I can show you the eye assembly is two parts. So I have my eye, and you can see, oops, it got away from me. So you can see the tip here, and then you have the back side. And the back side has kind of a curve downward. And so that curve downward is the inside part. Okay? So you're going to put that part on top. So it looks like this. And then you push it all the way down. The thing that I do when I put the eyes in is you don't want to have too much of a hole where you put your eye into your horse. Now you can see this little string I have placed here. I used an old tailor's trick, and instead of putting an ink dot here, I just put a piece of thread in and tied it off so I would know where to poke my hole. Now, I like to use my seam ripper to poke the hole for the eye because it makes a very small hole. And then what I do is I take the bottom of the eye and I put it through the small hole and then stretch the material over the tip until it finally breaks through. And what this does is it makes a really tight fit so that the eye doesn't move around. And so that's my recommendation when you add the eyes. Now next what we have to do is we have to sew the nose. So we're going to fold it in half, pin it, and then make a seam right across the nose. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I'll come back with you and we'll work on adding the underside of the face. Okay, we're back. Now we were adding the underside to the upper side, and I have done all that for you. So let me first review where we are so far. So the upper side, we have sewn our seam across the top and added our ear, right? And we did that on both sides and added our eyes. Then we sewed across the tip of the nose to create the upper. Then we have to add the underside. So the underside is piece number 14, and where we're going to sew right along the bottom here first, and that's going to create the chin. So I'll show you the underside. You can see how that works together. Actually, it looks like this. So there's your fold, and then you sew across here to create the chin. Now once we've done that, we match up the seam from the chin and the nose. And then we pin across the muzzle area, the nose area, and follow all the way around to the edge. Now I recommend that you start by pinning a little bit on the nose and then go and pin the edge here to make sure you're going to get that fit all the way to the edge. And then go back and pin along this edge, doing that on both sides, and then simply sew all the way around. Be careful when you're sewing this part right here. It gets a little thick, but you want to make sure that you line up these seams. The reason why you want to do that is those seams actually create the smile or the mouth, and I'm going to turn it inside out so you can see. It's now starting to look like a horse. So you can see the seams right here. You can see where this creates a mouth and this comes up into the nose and then this down here drops down into a chin. You can start to see the formation. And of course, the seams that we started up through the top here, they create nice little kind of snout or nose lines. And it works out just ever so cute. This top open area is where we're going to insert the mane. If you're going to add the unicorn happens right at the tip of this area. However, when you pull the unicorn pattern, the fantasy pattern down, you'll see that I have replaced it with a different head that has the marking of where the unicorn is going to go. Now you have two options on how you're going to add that unicorn. You can add it to an already made horse by just folding the bottom side under and stitch it around. Maybe use a little bit of fabric glue to kind of secure it, or you can do it by cutting open right here on the cutting line, and then we put our unicorn on top of that and whip stitch all the way around. Now, I like the idea of a whip stitch because it gives me a little bit more control in that really small circle area. If you're a pro with the sewing machine and you would prefer to sew with the sewing machine, that's of course fine as well. Now let's talk about that unicorn. It's just a little triangle. And these marks here are going to give that unicorn shape, that kind of curly cube shape that moves up. So what we do is we actually sew with our sewing machine on these lines with the pattern on your piece. That way you can make sure you get the lines just perfect. Then you'll take the pattern and just pull it away. Start by pulling on one section, pull down, and then you'll pull the other because it'll be perforated from the needle. And you'll be able to pull the pattern off and leave your stitching behind. Now we want to make sure that we leave lots of extra string on each one of these sews. So don't sew it in one continuous. Make one sewing seam line here, then another one here with lots of extra string, because we're going to gather just a little bit so that we can make the indentations of our horn. So I'll give you an example. Here's the one that I did, and you can see that I pulled in the lines, I pulled in the string just a little bit so that we can create that horn. You want to make sure that you leave a little bit of extra line and tie it off. So you can see how I have these extra strings out here. And then I tied them in knots to make sure that they don't pull out during play. And then when you put it inside out, or right side out, then you get your unicorn. So you can see it's a very simple process. Next time we get together, we're going to put the head onto the neck and the legs, and then we'll attach that to the main body, and we'll have the outside of our horse completed. We'll follow up with a video of how to make the internal structure and stuff your horse, and then you'll be ready to play. I'm so glad that you're sticking with it. Once you finish, you're going to get the bug, and you're going to need to make a few more. I think I have 3 or 4 now. Thank you so much for continuing with your project. If you have any questions or any problems, remember, you can email me directly. My email address is Ellen, E-L-L-E-N, at via-e.com. I look forward to talking to you soon. Bye.